Hello children, once again welcome back. So we have completed lesson 1 successfully. I feel that I have done my teaching justifiably, but only if you can understand I'll feel more satisfied. I just wish that you really enjoyed the lesson. Now coming to the second life process that we are going to learn in our class 10. Now this life process is all about breathing. In our primary classes, we learnt about breathing means taking in oxygen and releasing carbon dioxide. And we also learned that the organs involved in that is only lungs, nose, trachea, like that we learnt. That's all. And now we'll think that means breathing involves only from here to here. That's all. There ends the process. In such case, what is it there for? If it is only for breathing in and breathing out, what is the purpose of it? It is not just that, children, but when we were younger, we didn't get all these doubts. But after learning your first lesson, you might have understood that maybe there is something more important to learn in this. Have you ever thought of one question? We are breathing in oxygen, then how is that oxygen becoming carbon dioxide and coming out? Some of you might have thought, but sometimes what happens is we get thoughts, we get doubts, we'll think that the whole world is breathing in oxygen and breathing out carbon dioxide. Why should only I get that out? People may laugh at me. That will stop us from learning more, children. Ask any doubt that you get. Now, even I was having this doubt, but I never questioned. That's why I think I missed out on many chances of learning more. I don't want you to think like that. Whether it is, whatever question it is, children, it is not foolish for you. For others, it may look foolish or silly, but for you, it is important. What is important for you is important for you, that's all. Forget about the remaining people, rest of the world. If you want to know something, then ask. Get it clarified. Never hold yourself back. Okay? Now, we are breathing in oxygen and what is coming out is carbon dioxide. How did it happen? The question now is, how did it happen? Automatically, oxygen will become take carbon and then it becomes CO2 and come out. That means so much process is involved. In our body, life process means it is not just related from here to here. That's all, from here to here. That is not related like that. From here to here, the organs are there, but from there it is connected to remaining organ systems. That particular organ is connected to different organ systems. Other organ systems have to function means this organ system has to function properly. Oh, I'm confusing you, but I'm enjoying confusing you. I told you before only we have many organ systems. What are they? Digestive system, respiratory system, reproductive system, excretory system, circulatory system, and then skeletal system, muscular system, like that, hormonal system. Nervous system, like that we have 9 systems present. Every single system is related to another system, children. Every single system is related to another system. In 9th class you learnt that blood carries oxygen and carbon dioxide. From where is this blood carrying? Blood is carrying oxygen and carbon dioxide, but as far as what do we understand, the oxygen is going into the lungs and carbon dioxide is coming out of the lungs. Only that much we know. So, how is this that oxygen and carbon dioxide are present in the blood which is there in my leg also? That is what we are going to learn in our lesson. And this is not just about breathing, it is about respiration. A little more detailed. So, let us see. Respiration. What is the name of the lesson? Respiration, the energy generating system. The energy producing system. The energy producing system. The energy producing system. Now, respiration we understood. Breathing in oxygen and breathing out carbon dioxide is respiration. But that is only breathing. That is producing energy. That is producing energy. How is it producing energy? And till now what we thought? Food produces energy is what we thought. How can fruit produce energy? That means there is some connection between food and respiration, and the resultant is energy. And from where do you get the food? We get food from digestive system. When it is related to respiration, then the energy is produced. So now with all these small details, let us see food. What we understood is food produces energy, and now respiration is producing energy, we are thinking. That means food is related to digestive system and respiratory system. Digestive system and respiratory system together give energy. How are they both working together to give energy is what we are going to learn in our present lesson. Before we learn about this, we need to learn about discovery of gases and discovery of respiration. Discovery of gases and discovery of respiration. Before that, let us know much more about respiration. What is respiration? Respiration means producing energy by taking in oxygen, burning nutrients. That's all. Let us see once again. Production of energy by burning nutrients in presence of oxygen. Wonderful. Once again, production of energy by burning nutrients in presence of oxygen is called respiration. Does it mean that in absence of oxygen, no energy is produced? In absence of oxygen also, energy is produced. That is called anaerobic respiration. In presence of oxygen, the burning of nutrients takes place. We call it as aerobic respiration. There are two types of respiration. In presence of oxygen, energy is produced by burning the nutrients. We call it as aerobic. In absence of oxygen, when energy is produced by burning the nutrients, we call it as anaerobic respiration. That is about respiration. But first, we have to learn when the oxygen is discovered, when the carbon dioxide is discovered. Without that, how will we know? Then, we need to know about Joseph Priestley. What we need to learn is about Joseph Priestley. Joseph Priestley is the first scientist who understood that with his bell jar experiment. In first lesson, we learned, no? With his bell jar experiment, he understood that the organisms are breathing in something which is good and releasing something which is polluting the atmosphere. That what is released by the organisms, which is polluted by the organisms, is taken by the plants, and plants are releasing something to purify the atmosphere. That is again taken by the animals, and again they are releasing something polluting, and that polluted gas is taken by the plants, and plants are again purifying. Again, that is going like a cycle like this. So Joseph Priestley discovered oxygen, but who gave the name, coined the name oxygen is Lavoisier. So we need to remember Joseph Priestley who discovered oxygen, Lavoisier who coined oxygen. Okay. Next, what is important is they also understood that some vitiated gas is present. Now see in your textbook, page number 25, if you see, in 18th century only Lavoisier and Priestley made us to understand. Now let us see, can it be said that Priestley's experiment helped us to find out more about composition of air and how? Of course, we understood that something, like I told you with this bell jar experiment, he said that organisms are releasing something which is polluting the air, and plants are releasing, taking that and releasing something to purify the air. So we understood that composition of gas, in that composition this polluted air is there and purifying air is there. We learnt a little more about that. And then Lavoisier also carried out several experiments, and he understood that heating powdered charcoal in a bell jar kept over the water in a trough was like fixed air. What did he do? He heated charcoal powder. Charcoal powder he lighted and he heated on a trough. Trough means just a small vessel. And that he called it as fixed air. It released something like fixed air. In those days, carbon dioxide was known as fixed air. In those days, what is carbon dioxide known as? Fixed air. Lavoisier named oxygen, but carbon dioxide was not named by him. It was called as fixed air. And then, a next series of experiments, with the combustion of phosphorus in a bell jar. What did he notice? These studies made him to understand that atmospheric air which combined with phosphorus was not water vapor. whatever is combining with phosphorus is not water vapor. Something else is coming out. What is that? His final words are there, and are that substance which combines with phosphorus is either air itself or another elastic fluid present in certain proportion in the air which we breathe. So something we are breathing, that is being produced. It is not air. It is not water vapor. And then this was respirable air. What is this? This is respirable air, and that's why he named it as oxygen. What was produced by combustion according to Lavoisier? At combustion, what is produced? Fixed air is produced. What is produced? What did Lavoisier find out about air from his experiments? From his experiments, what did he understand is that air has many components, many gases present in it, which is, and one of it is the air that we breathe. What conclusion can be drawn from Lavoisier's experiment is that the air has many gases, including fixed air and the air that we breathe and water vapor and other gases also. Lavoisier noted that there was a profound difference between the air in which combustion of a metal had been carried out and the one which had served for respiration. Okay, that means he understood that there is one type of air which is useful for our respiration. The air that we breathe out, precipitated lime water. The air that we breathe in is different. He understood. And the air that we breathe out is another thing. He understood. Now again, one more thing he understood is that the air we breathe out is precipitating lime water to turn it into milky colored. That means chalky colored. So, and let us see, water, well, that after heating metal did not. Once again, let us have clarity. The air that we breathe out is turning lime water milky, precipitating lime water to milky. But the air that is released by burning metal is not turning lime water milky. That means metal burning is releasing some other gas, but not carbon dioxide. We are releasing something else, fixed air, which can turn lime water milky. So many things have scientists did not come to a decision that these are carbon dioxide, this is oxygen, by simply doing just one experiment or two experiments. They have done innumerable experiments, a series of experiments have made them to come to a conclusion that the air or the atmosphere contains of various gases and combustion takes place differently and releases different types of gases with different types of metals and different types of organisms. It is different. So tomorrow we will learn much more about this and the scientists involved in this also. And I want you to read the textbook and come prepared. Thank you so much. Have a good day.